Hey, what's up, y'all? Jay from Jay's Lawn Service here, back with another one. Today, we're trimming a few crepe myrtles on the last day of winter. When it comes to trimming crepe myrtles, you must ask yourself these three questions. Should I top off this crepe myrtle? When is the best time to trim a crepe myrtle? And what is crepe murder? Topping off is where you do just like the phrase suggests. You give that some bitch a flat top. Bang! Just like that. Now, this is where the controversy lies. Some landscapers even call this method crepe murder. So here's the thing. In my opinion, it all comes down to where on the crepe myrtle did you top it off. There's no correct measurement for this because every tree is different. If you top it off too low, the tree is more susceptible to damage and it looks stupid because it has no shape. This is what I believe many people are referring to when they say crepe murder. On the other hand, I believe if you top it off at the right place, you can produce beautiful results. The other method most people use is where they trim and maintain the base of the tree up to a certain level while letting the canopy grow. I'm going to call this method trimming the base. This is the method I've been using on these particular crepe myrtles for the last 4 years. During that time, I've had many different experiences with crepe myrtles on other properties. I have trimmed up the base, I've topped off, and I have also committed crepe murder. If the customer wants crepe murder, I always advise them to the best of my ability, but at the end of the day, the tree belongs to them. My job is to make the customer happy, and if the customer knows better and still wants crepe murder, then I'm your crepe myrtle hitman. Bang! Crepe murder it is! It's important to know that crepe myrtles are very trimmable and extremely resilient. Out of all the crepe myrtles I've ever trimmed, and I've had my fair share, I've never killed a tree. They've all bounced back and are healthy today, even the ones I quote-unquote murdered. My advice to someone who has never trimmed crepe myrtles before would be to do your research. Find a few people on YouTube, not just one or two people, who seem to know what they're talking about. Watch a few videos, read a few articles, and make your own mind up about what is the right way or the wrong way to trim a crepe myrtle. Once you have an informed opinion, you can advise your customers of what method is best for their situation. Remember, the end result you are looking for is a happy customer. Hopefully you have informed them well enough to where they can make a solid decision. If they don't follow your advice, don't take it personally. If you have informed your customer to the best of your ability and they still choose to commit crepe murder, then you're either going to have to do what you have to do to make the customer happy, or if your conscience just can't handle it, you're going to have to walk away from the job. Is it really that serious to you? That's the question you're going to have to ask yourself when you enter the world of crepe myrtle maintenance. Here's how I trim mine. I ask the customer what results they want so I can determine what method I'm going to use. The customer's budget is also a factor in this equation. Trimming the base is easier, faster, and produces less waste, therefore it's cheaper. Topping it off properly, not crepe murder, takes longer, is more difficult, and produces more waste, therefore it's more expensive. For me, the ideal situation is to top off the tree properly at the beginning, then trim the base while the canopy gets bigger over the next 3 years or so. Then you can see how the tree is growing and decide if and when you want to top it off again, or if you want to let the canopy continue to grow. As far as when to trim your crepe myrtle, late winter is the best time. You can trim just before the tree comes out of dormancy. That way, when the tree does come out of dormancy, all of the new energy the tree produces will be used to make new shoots. This is what will give your crepe myrtle the beautiful blooms in late spring and early summer. It doesn't matter if you are trimming up the base or topping off. The whole idea is to make the tree look nice and neat. Look for sucker trees growing around the base and remove them along with any new growth that has sprouted below where you topped it off. These particular trees have not been topped off in at least 4 years. Today we are topping them off and bringing them back to a more manageable size. Some people choose to top off their crepe myrtles every year. That is totally acceptable. However, do not top them off at the same spot. If you do, the crepe myrtles will grow those ugly knots we have all seen. Instead, trim about 6 to 12 inches higher than you did the year before. This method also makes the trees look more uniform and neat, while preventing the ugly knots and enabling new shoots to grow in a more flattering way. I'm trimming these trees about a foot above where they were last topped off 4 years ago. Here is the final result of our trimming. When the summer starts, I'll do an update video to show how the crepe myrtle is growing after it has been trimmed using this method. Let me know in the comments how you trim crepe myrtles. Am I wrong? Am I right? How do you do it? I'm always willing to learn and change the way I do things when I find a better way. I hope y'all are the same. Well, that's about it for this one. I hope this video has brought you some type of value. If it has, please drop me a like and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see y'all in the next video. Y'all be safe. Take care.